This is Raider News Update with Bianca DiMaria and Jasmine Charles with the news, Tyler Hubbard with Arts and Entertainment, and Jody Cornwell with Sports. And now, from Studio B at Scotch Plains Fanwood High School, Bianca DiMaria and Jasmine Charles.
Welcome to Period 4-5 edition of Raider News Update. I'm Bianca DiMaria. Former South African President Nelson Mandela, who served 27 years in prison for anti-apartheid activities and led his continent into a new era, has recently died at age 95. The civil rights activist would become a key figure in South Africa's move to end the country's notorious corrupt regime. The impact of his efforts would ultimately reach well beyond South Africa's borders and earn him a Nobel Peace Prize in 1993. Mandela's death comes months after his 95th birthday on July 18th, which his foundation, various charities, and businesses vowed to celebrate with a nationwide day of service that includes painting schools, handing out food and books, and running a 41-mile relay marathon in the spirit of Mandela's 67 years of activism and public work. This is a season when SCN seeks to match donors with recipients in Project Angel Tree. Let's go on location to find out more.
Hi, I'm on location with Kim Cotty, a member of SCN. So Kim, could you explain a little bit about Project Angel Tree this year?
Yeah, Angel Tree is when we get a list of children who come from troubling neighborhoods who can't afford Christmas presents this year. So we get a list of their names, their age, their size, and the toys that they want this year. And then some people do it individually and go out and get the stuff for them, and some people raise money in their homerooms and then go buy the toys that they want.
So do you need any more people to sign up, or are you good?
Well, we usually get a lot of people to sign up, but it would never hurt to have more people because the kids do ask for varied items and not everyone can get everything that's on the item. So yeah, we can always need more people.
So where can someone sign up?
If you go to Mr. Stevens' room, he has a list of all the people, and also I think everyone's homeroom teacher should have a list of all the kids.
Thank you, Kim.
You're welcome.
And back to the studio.
On Wednesday, December 11th, the high school hosted the Fall Sports Awards from 7 to 10 p.m. All athletes were mentioned in high honor. Congratulations to all fall athletes for a great season. Approximately 1 year ago, on December 14th, the tragic killing of 20 elementary school kids and 7 staff members occurred at Newtown Elementary School in Newtown, Connecticut. It was a devastating event for everyone in America, and it will never be forgotten. We honor these young children and brave adults. Our thoughts and prayers go out to everyone in Newtown and the family and friends of the people who were affected. And now let's go to Arts and Entertainment with Tyler.
Thanks, Bianca. The top 5 songs of this week are number 5, Counting Stars by OneRepublic, number 4, Timber by Pitbull featuring Kesha, number 3, Royals by Lorde, number 2, The Monster by Eminem featuring Rihanna, and coming in at number 1 is Wrecking Ball by Miley Cyrus. The top 5 movies of this week are number 5, Delivery Man, number 4, Thor, The Dark World, number 3, Out of the Furnace, number 2, Hunger Games: Catching Fire, and coming in at number 1, Disney's Frozen. The 2014 Grammy Award nominees have been announced. Macklemore and Ryan Lewis and Kendrick Lamar will square off in 2 of the night's biggest categories, Best New Artist and Album of the Year. While many familiar names such as Taylor Swift and Bruno Mars will be seen, there are new names that have surfaced. Lorde, one of the newest and youngest nominees, has been nominated for 2 categories, Best Pop Solo Performance and Best Pop Vocal Album. Robin Thicke, made popular by his song Blurred Lines, has been nominated in 3 categories, Best Pop Duo Group Performance, Record of the Year, and Best Pop Vocal Album. The show will be broadcasted on January 26, 2014 at 8 o'clock p.m. on CBS. Now let's go to Critics' Corner.
Seen it multiple times, I can't get through it. I really cannot stand watching it. Not to say that Ian McKellen doesn't make a good performance, not to say that Elijah Woods doesn't make a good performance, and not to say that the idea isn't interesting, but me personally, I don't see what the big deal is. I think it's a very overrated franchise. I personally do not like it.
You're not allowed to take shots at the franchise as a whole because the franchise as a whole is great. We're only talking about this movie. Thank you very much, Mr. Getz. I went to a movie with you. It was about a year back, and you fell asleep about 20 minutes in. Hold up, I'm not done. You fell asleep about 20 minutes in, woke up for about maybe 2 minutes, and then fell asleep till the end of the movie. Do you remember what movie that was, Matt?
Let the Sky Fall.
Skyfall is filled with action, and it's one of the better James Bond installments. And he fell asleep in that. So I think Matt's lack of focus should not be put into our judging of Fellowship of the Ring.
I'm going to defend myself right now. That day I had these eye drops put in and it made me very sleepy and I couldn't see the screen.
That's a lie.
And second of all, I've never really been a big fan of the James Bond series either.
Oh my God, we're not talking about this right now.
But in the fact that I fall asleep during movies, I rarely fall asleep during movies. I recently just saw Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs 2.
How did you not fall asleep in that?
And it was such a good movie.
We're not.
But you want to know the difference is that I enjoy watching movies that are not fantasy. And when I'm watching this movie, all I can think about is people role-playing the characters and being in this fantasy world, and I personally just can't get to that level of commitment. Well, I'll argue Star Wars days after days after days, but not this movie.
Fly, you fools!
Well, I think it's time to give our scoring. Because of the fact you're fantastic acting, beautiful direction and camera work, great set design, and although it is a little slow at times, so I will give it, it's a 4 out of 5 for me.
Now, you think I'm going to bash this completely, but I'm going to give it a 2.5 out of 5. Mainly because, like, it's not the worst movie I've ever seen. And it's certainly not bad, but it's just not for me.
I'm Phil Tice.
I'm Matt Getz.
And this has been Classics Critics Corner.
Now let's go to major events of the week.
Hi, welcome to this week's major events. I'm Michaela.
And I'm Stephanie.
On Monday, December 16th, the boys and girls varsity swim teams go against Summit at 3 p.m. at Summit YMCA. Wednesday, December 18th, the boys varsity ice hockey team goes against Westfield at 8:30 p.m. at Warnico Park.
Upcoming movies for this week include Anchorman 2, The Legend Continues, starring Will Ferrell, Walking with Dinosaurs 3D, and The Past, starring Veronese Vejo, all coming on theaters December 20th.
Now back to the studio.
And now let's go to sports with Jody.
Thanks, Bianca. The winter sports season has just begun. Some teams are getting ready for their seasons to begin, while others have already started playing official games. Now let's go on location with a member of the bowling team to find out more.
I'm on location with a member of the boys varsity bowling team, Sam Mahler. So Sam, how did you guys do last season?
Well, last season we came in 5th place in the Union County tournament, and we missed the sectional cut by about 70 pins. So it wasn't a bad season overall, but we're looking to improve this year.
That's awesome. So what are your goals for this season?
Well, our main goals are to win the county tournament and then advance into the state sectional finals, which is something we haven't done in a long time.
That'd be cool. So who are your captains for this season?
The captains are the seniors, John Burgos and Nariah Walker.
Okay, thank you, Sam. Now back to the studio.
Now let's go on location to find out the track team's goals for their winter season.
Hi, I'm on location with varsity winter track athlete Amber Simmons. Hi, Amber.
Hi.
So how's the season going so far?
Actually, the season hasn't started yet.
So when does it start?
Our first meet is December 21st. It's a relay meet, so I'm really looking forward to it.
So since the season didn't start yet, do you still have goals, what you want to accomplish this year?
Yeah, I definitely want to make it to counties and, you know, win and get a lot of medals, more medals than I got last season, so.
That's good. I know it's a little bit early, but how about college plans? You want to continue track or, you know, something different?
I'm considering it. I still have time to think, but definitely I'm taking it into consideration because I'm maybe the best option, so.
All right, well, thanks, Amber.
Thank you.
Now back to the studio.
And now let's go on location with a member of the boys varsity basketball team to find out what they hope to achieve this season.
I'm on location with Michael, varsity player Michael Doneforth. Hello.
Hello.
So how's the season going so far?
So far, so good.
How was your scrimmage this Sunday?
Our scrimmage was good.
What are your personal goals for this season?
To make it far in the States. You know, make a run. We're the underdog, so, you know, we're a young team.
Have you decided on your captains?
No, we don't know that yet.
Now back to studio.
That wraps up for sports. Now back to Bianca.
Thanks, Jody. Now let's go to Car of the Week.
Another one. Another one.
Yeah.
Stay down on my day one day. Gonna be in the club screaming, no new friends. No new friends. No new friends. No, no, no.
DJ Khaled.
Still here on my day one day. So you hear me say, no new friends. No new friends. No new friends. No, no, no. Still ride with my day one day. I don't really need no new friends. No new friends. No new friends. No, no, no. Stay down from day one, so I say, no new friends, no new friends, no new friends, no, no, no. Stay down from day one, so I say, no new friends, no new friends, no new friends, no, no, no. Stay down from day one, so I say.
Man, this shit so ill that we had to restart it. H time on second home, like I'm James Harden. Money counter go brrr when you starting out the garden. Four car garage.
This is a tough car you got here. What kind is it?
It's a Ford Mustang.
And what kind of horsepower do you have in a thing like this?
I guess about 300 horsepower.
What about the engine?
It's a V6 engine.
And what do you like to do in this car?
I like to drive.
That's cool. Here's the interior of the car. We have these nice leather seats and automatic transmission. What else do you have?
Convertible. Top goes down. It's pretty nice. All the ladies love it.
That's good to hear.
This has been Car of the Week. Now back to the studio.
No new friends. No new friends. No new friends. No, no, no.
DJ Khaled!
Still here on my day one.
And now let's go to this week's weather with Stormy Stephanie.
Hello, I'm Stormy Stephanie, and winter has arrived. This week's weather features temperatures in the 30s, and it will be partly cloudy and sunny this whole week. Now back to the studio.
That wraps it up for this week's Period 4-5 edition of Raider News Update. Be sure to tune in next week for Period 7-8 edition.
Arts and Entertainment. And
6 at Johnson's Park in Piscataway, New Jersey, DECA participated in the Lupus Walk. The purpose of this walk is to educate and support those affected by lupus and to find a cure.
The shoes collected will be given to the needy people in our local area. If you are interested in donating any shoes, bring them to Mr. Stevens in room 152.
This past week at SPFHS was School Spirit Week. School Spirit Week consists of 5 major events which include different themes. Monday was Lazy Monday, where students were encouraged to wear their pajamas at school.
The girls' soccer team has been on a roll as of late. After starting off their campaign with 4 losses in their first 4 games, the squad has won 5 straight matches.
Rosetta Rice-Gossin with Arts and Entertainment and Ed Cezalli with Sports.